And now we will learn how to edit existing transactions. This video is an overview of basic mistake fixing, and we will learn more advanced techniques on how to find and fix mistakes in later videos. The trial balance is a summary report. This means it shows the results of transactions or the accumulated totals of each account. However, the customer balance detail is what we call a detail report. That means it lists the transactions one by one. You can edit any transaction just by double-clicking directly on the transaction. So, what does that mean? Well, if I click Reports and I go over to the customer balance detail, because this is what we call a detail type of report, each individual transaction is listed on the detail. Any report that shows the transactions allows you to double-click and open up the transaction, and you can change almost anything you want. For example, let's take a look at invoice number 3 for Candy Charles. See this one for $3,300? If we double-click anywhere in this line, we can go back to the actual window where we recorded invoice number 3. Good. Now that invoice number 3 is in front of us, we can change any of the fields of information that we previously put in, and then when we save our changes, all of the reports will change accordingly. For example, let's only change the quantity from 11 to 11,000. Now, as soon as I push the tab key to save this field, notice QuickBooks multiplies and gives us a giant number. This invoice went from 3,300 to 3,300,000 just by changing the little numbers here and pushing tab. The reports are not affected yet, but when I click save and then I close the window, you can see that our customer balance detail has changed. This invoice is now giant, and that makes Candy's balance ginormous, which means that the total accounts receivable has changed to an astronomical number. Now, do you think that the customer balance detail is the only report that has changed? Of course not. This invoice also affects your trial balance and a lot of other reports that we haven't gotten to yet. But if we go back to reports and we take a look at the trial balance, you can see the numbers have become huge as a result of the change, as a result of changing one number in one invoice. All the numbers in all the reports that invoice affects will change. Now, if you double-click on any summary number, you can see all of the transactions that the number includes. So, if we come back here, and we know the trial balance is a summary, if you take a look at video income, this number is supposed to be the total of all the invoices that have video income listed as the item. If we double-click, we can open up the number, and now we see the reason why video income is this total. It lists every single transaction that was recorded in the video income account. Now we can clearly see that the January 3rd invoice number 3 is the problem. And of course, because after we double-clicked, we got what we call a transaction report, well, this report lists the transactions, so we can double-click right on the transaction that's the problem. And now that we're back at the window for invoice number 3, we can again change anything we want. Let's click back and change it back to the proper number 11, push tab to save the field. Then when I click save, you will see that when you go back to the trial balance, all the numbers, let's go to reports, trial balance, and you can see all the numbers have come back to normal. That's the way that I suggest you find and fix mistakes after this exercise. If you double click on any number, you can get all of the transactions that add up to that number. So if your result is different from mine, you can go through them one by one to find the different number. And as soon as you find a transaction that has a different number, you can, or a different money amount, you can double click and change anything you want.